Dear organizers, distinguished guests, dear fighters against cancer, I will not speak about the known figures. I will even not speak about the reports we adopted in the European Parliament, resolutions, conferences, workshops, panels, seminars, and so on. I think it is time for gratitude, for evaluation, for new ideas and new commitments. I would like to thank the National Institute of Public Health, European Commission, all presiding countries and all other partners for the work done in these years. I think we can say we feel stronger. We can speak about an added value while exercising the Partnership Against Cancer action in Europe. And I would say it is not just about action or activism, it is about philosophy, about working paradigm. Partnership, in my opinion, is just another expression of the idea of working together, which was one of two main ideas of the founding fathers of the European Union. And I would like to emphasize the role and expectations of the European citizens. European citizens should enjoy the added value that and benefits because they are living together in the same union. And we usually realize areas and possibilities, opportunities to do more together. There are many actions or many sectors where only union can act, can provide an added value. One or two members or many member states cannot do that, are not able to do that. And I see in my already second mandate in the European Parliament that European citizens expect more from the Union. And there is certain criticism about the functioning of the Union, but there are also good signs. We can say that European Union does function. I will not speak about the banking union, which I think will provide not only economic consequences, but also political consequences once the union will fully function. There is cross-border patient care, which is again a proof that European Union is on the side of the patients. And I will repeat again also here in Ljubljana that this decision, this directive, will not lead just to the mobility of the patients, as some medical doctors fear, but it will definitely have as a consequence the mobility of knowledge, what is extremely needed. You know that members of the European Parliament don't like inequalities. Inequalities, as far as cancer is concerned, are the most used words in the European Parliament. And we don't like, as citizens, don't like such differences with regard to the methodology of cancer registries and the differences or even the absence of the cancer control plans in some countries. So we really like that the knowledge, the excellence is shared. And again, European Union here and European Commission, first of all, can provide, can with additional effort really provide a new added value. I would like to tell you that in the European Parliament, not just those who are members of the group, parliamentary group Members Against Cancer, you know, for 10 years already, also our other colleagues are attentive to the cancer, which remains one of the main burdens in the European Union. What we wish is definitely more dynamics. We think that some duties or some tasks we could exercise in a shorter time. We also dispose with our own resources. ISPRA was mentioned already today. We think that we need more Europe in that respect as well. I would evaluate EPAC as a very good experience. I was able to follow it, to evaluate it as a member of the European Parliament, and I think it is worth to continue. There are good elements, there is a success, there are areas where we think we could do more, but I think speaking generally, IPAC has been a good experience. And I'm really pleased by the words of the Commissioner Borg, who I think I would consider as a kind of Saint Nicholas for cancer patients, because I see very strong commitment on his side, and this does not mean just him, because I think that health and cancer is getting more attention in the European Commission as a whole. So I was really pleased by those words. I would like only to assure you that European Parliament will support this ambition to do more for cancer patients in the European Union. I would like to conclude by expressing my gratitude to all those who cooperated in this partnership. I can say, you know, I'm sometimes very critical member of the European Parliament, but I ask many times for better coordination between the main European institutions. I'm more pleased after 9 years or 10 years of work than I was at the beginning, and I think that there is a ground to continue with that work. And I would like to emphasize at the end one more keyword. This is civil society. These are NGOs. These are patient organizations, medical doctors' organizations. I think that within this partnership, we were able to establish a good working spirit at the European level, in the member states. Many partnerships were done or are alive. And especially for the European Parliament, for the deputies, it is important that we have such a close relation and cooperation with the civil society organizations, with NGOs. So I would like to assure you that we will share this ambition to do more. Sometimes we even wish to do more than the Commission, then you know how are the procedures. I do hope that with more partnership, we will finally reach also less cancer. I wish you all the best and lots of success in that spirit. Thank you.